doesn't have to be hard to build a website. It's all about choosing the right tools that make building a website easy. I'm Tim Martin, and this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to make a website with WordPress. This video is all about setting up a foundation to allow you to really jump ahead and build an awesome looking website quickly. Doesn't matter if you want to make a blog, or an internet business website, an affiliate marketing website, or just a website for a small business. This video is the foundation that's gonna help you get started. After this foundation video, I'm gonna introduce you to some hacks and some hints that I've learned that will allow you to make your website look like it was designed by a professional. I also have several other tutorials that will show you how to design your own awesome pages step by step. And if that seems a little bit too tough, I actually offer all of those pages from my tutorials as free page templates that you can download from my website. In fact, I've got a listing of a whole bunch of free page templates that you can use so you can really get a jump start on putting your website together. As I said, I want to make it as easy as possible for you to build a website. The faster you can get your website up and running, hopefully, the sooner you'll be able to achieve whatever it is that you want to do with your website. So, if you want to make an awesome website, let's do this. WordPress is definitely my favorite way to build a website. I've tried building websites with a lot of other platforms like Joomla, Drupal, Wix, Squarespace, and even Weebly. But when it comes down to it, I always come back to WordPress. With the right tools and setup, WordPress can be just as easy to use as some of those others, but WordPress offers way, way more options and versatility than the other website platforms. So we're gonna need a few things to get our WordPress website up and running. And the first thing that we're gonna need is a website hosting account. Website hosting is where your website is going to live and how it's going to be accessed across the internet. The second thing that we're gonna need is a domain name, and that's the name of your website. So for example, my website is www.realwebsitehints.com. Apple has apple.com and Google has google.com. And then the third thing that we're gonna need is to just install WordPress. And actually, all three of these things are really easy to do, and they all basically happen when we sign up for our website hosting. And then after we sign up for our website hosting, there's a few more things that we need to just get out of the way. We're gonna need to configure WordPress and make sure that everything is set up the way we want so that we can start building our website. And then the last thing that we need to do is to just install an awesome WordPress theme that's gonna allow us to build and design our own pages easily, and then to take advantage of that huge library of free website templates. So those are the basic steps, and that's what we're gonna cover in this video. So the first step is signing up for a hosting company. And there's a lot of choices when it comes down to website hosting. And I've personally purchased and tested a lot of them. So some examples of the hosting companies that I've tried are BlueHost, Dreamhost, SiteGround, GoDaddy, iPage, HostGators, and then there's several more. And for this tutorial, I decided to show you guys how to set up your website with SiteGround. I have a few other hosting companies that I also recommend, and if for some reason you don't want to use SiteGround, you can check those out by clicking on the link up above here. And I've got videos that will also show you exactly how to get your website set up using those hosting companies instead. I decided to show you guys how to set up your website with SiteGround because I think that SiteGround ticks a lot of the boxes for what people want from a hosting company. In my experience, they offer a really great, friendly, and fast customer service. And then everyone is always obsessed with like making their website run as fast as possible in website speed. And in my recent test, I tested SiteGround over a couple of months, and it just eked ahead on the Google PageSpeed Insight score for being the fastest of the website hosting companies that I tested. And they consistently seem to deliver the highest score in that category. SiteGround also offers several data center choices, so it doesn't really matter where you are in the world, you can choose a data center that's close to where you are. And the benefit of having a data center close to where you are is it's gonna make it just a little bit faster when you're working on your website. So let's go over to the computer and I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through everything that we need to do step by step. Now SiteGround offers a lot of different types of hosting plans and I recommend going with their WordPress specific hosting. So you can follow along with this tutorial, I've included a link down below that will take you directly to their WordPress hosting options. This link is an affiliate link and I'll be sure to include any discounts that I can offer on their hosting. If you get hosting with SiteGround, I'll get a commission, and that helps me to test website building tools and to offer free tutorials and free website templates on my channel and on my website. So we've got three basic plans for hosting. The first plan here is our startup plan. It'll allow you to build one website. It's got 10 gigabytes of space, which really is plenty of space. You get free daily backups. I mean, it's got everything that you need here in the basic plan. Now, if you step up to the Grow Big plan, which I think is what I'm gonna sign up for in this particular case, you get priority technical support, the WordPress Super Cacher, which is something that's gonna help your website load faster, and then you get 30 backup copies that are available, and you get free backup restores. All right, so let's just go ahead and click on Get Started. And now here on this page, we've got the option to create a domain name. And my recommendation is to go with either a .com if you're at pretty much anywhere in the world, or if you're in, like, say, the United Kingdom and you've got the .co.uk to use that, or whatever the local sort of most commonly used, what they call those endings is they call them top-level domains. So you want to use the most commonly used top-level domain. Now, there's a lot of other options. If we click over here, we can see that there's just a bunch of different options. We've got the local ones, like I was saying, the country-specific ones, and then we've got, like, .camp, .academy, .coffee. I think that those can be good choices, and I'm sure in the future they're going to be great choices, but I just sort of feel right now that a lot of people don't even know that those exist, so I'd be a little bit hesitant to recommend you doing that. So what I would suggest you do is come up with a domain name that speaks to your audience, that tells them directly about what your website is, and you know, maybe make it three or four words, because that's gonna be a little bit easier to find a domain name that's got three or four words since so many of the other .coms have been taken. So for example, my website, I created it and I called it Real Website Hints. So I got three words in there, tells you immediately what my website's about, and it's really easy to remember. So that's what I recommend for your domain name, is to pick something like that. Okay, and then here, all you gotta do is just fill out the basic information, fill out your email, password, so all the basic payment information. Then we scroll down here, we have our options for the data center we wanna use. You can select the data center. It should default to the data center that's closer to you. And then we have the length of time or the period that we want to sign up for our hosting. And then here you can decide whether you want hosting for 1 year, or up to 3 years. If you know you're really dedicated to this and you're gonna want to work on your website for a while and you're gonna just keep it up, you might wanna use one of the longer periods, and that's just gonna lock in that introductory rate for a longer period of time and help you save some money over that period of time. So that's something you might wanna consider. I'm just gonna go for the 12 months because that's all I need for this little test here. Now we've got extra services. We've got domain registration, so that's the domain that I just typed in. Now we've got domain privacy. Domain privacy is something I definitely recommend you do. What it does is it just hides your personal information from the domain registration. So it's gonna hide your address, phone number, email address, and all the things that you use to sign up for your account. And you might not care who knows that you own that domain. I think the real problem is that what I found when I didn't do it one time was that I just wound up with a bunch of spam emails, junk phone calls, and junk mail in my mailbox, and it was just really annoying. So for me, 12 bucks a year to avoid that, definitely worth it. And then the last thing is the SiteGround site scanner, and that's just gonna check your website for malware that may have been installed on your website. So it's a good idea to just know if your website's been hacked and have them check it for you. So I definitely recommend getting that also. And then after you filled all of that out, just click on the Pay Now button. Okay, and then now our site's been created, so we can just proceed to the customer area here by clicking on this button. And then I've got a setup wizard here. I'm gonna skip this setup wizard, so I'm gonna show you guys exactly how to set it up. And I've got my own sort of recommendation for like the best theme to use to get started building your website. So I'm just gonna go and click on this. But if you do have an existing website and you wanna transfer it, they do have a free option to transfer your website for you. And that can be a great way of doing it easily. Just click on thanks, but I don't need help, and then click on proceed. All right, so this here is your main account dashboard. And we just wanna go over here to my accounts. Okay, so this has got some of the basic information about our website. We've got email with this account, so if you want to use this email, I definitely recommend using something like Google Mail, but this is a great way to get started. So to access your email, you can do it here, and then we've got an email tutorial that'll show you exactly how to set that up. So that's a great way to get started with email. So let's go ahead and install WordPress. To do that, we're going to go to the seed panel. And then next, we just want to scroll down here to where it says WordPress Installer, and click on WordPress Installer. And it's gonna walk us through setting up WordPress. It's really easy to do. All right, so just click here where it says Install Now. And we wanna choose the protocol. You definitely wanna choose HTTPS. That's gonna make sure that it uses your SSL certificate, and that's sort of the standard that you need to be using now, so it's already set up for that. The domain name, so if you had multiple domain names on this account, which domain name you'd want it to be registered to. And in some cases, people add a different directory like /blog, and they have WordPress installed on there. Don't recommend that. I recommend just having it installed right here on your basic domain name. And then next, I'm just going to sort of pre-set up some of the settings for our site. So I'm going to type in a site name. And then you want to put in a little description about what your website's all about. We don't want to enable this, so just don't click on that. And then we've got an opportunity here to add in an admin username and password. Definitely recommend making something secure here. They've already sort of filled it out for you with a little bit of, with a secure name and a secure password. You might want to change that, but just make sure you save it someplace. I personally use LastPass to save all of my passwords, because when you're building a website, you've got just so many different usernames and passwords you're going to be signing up for, and you want to make sure you use a different and unique secure password on every service. That way, if one of them gets hacked, you still have your other passwords are secure. And then it's gonna set up an email admin for us. Now, this is a really important email address. It's gonna give us any alerts about your website. So for now, you can change it later. I would recommend just putting in an account that you have access to until you've set up and tested their email to make sure that that's working. And it does actually take, it can take a little bit of time for your domain name and your email to start working, because the domain name, once you sign up for it, it's got to get sent to all of these little domain name servers all across the internet. And depending on where you are, it can take a little bit of time for that. So I definitely recommend putting in an email address that you have access to right now for your admin email. And then you can change it to your domain name later on. So that's just something that I would recommend. The language you want to use, is there some plugins that they're asking you if you want to use? Definitely recommend using the limit login attempts, loginizer as they called it. What this does is it basically, if some bot, unfortunately hackers have bots out there, and they'll just sit on your website and just try all sorts of different kinds of usernames and passwords to log into your site, and it's a bad thing because they can easily hack into your website. What this plugin is going to do is it's going to only give them so many chances, and then it's going to lock them out of your site. So definitely want to put at least something like that. It's just a really basic way to secure your website. And then I've got a theme that I like to use, so I'm not going to install a theme here. So there we go. Now we can just click install. And it's just going to go ahead and sort of set up WordPress for it, get it all ready. And then the next thing we need to do is just configure WordPress and make sure everything's set up. Now, once WordPress has been installed, you're going to get an email that looks like this. It's going to have the information about your website, and it's going to show you where to log in. So for your website, you're going to log in at the name of your URL, so the URL you picked, and then /wp-admin. And then in that little wizard that we just set up, where we set up WordPress and it had that username and password, you're going to need to use that username and password to log into your website. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on this here. It's going to open up our website so we can start editing it. Just type in the username and password that you created, if you created one, or the one that was created for you. Okay, and so here we are on our website. Now let's just take care of the most important thing first, which is to make sure that some of the basic settings are set up right. And then I'll look at some of these other things, but I really wanna make sure you guys do this, because this is probably the most important thing for you to do. So we're gonna go over here to settings, and then we're gonna go to permalinks, probably the most important setting to set up. And what we wanna do is we wanna scroll down here to post name. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna make a nice name for all of our URLs. So when we create a post or we create a page, it's gonna have plain text. So in this example, so if you called your post, for example, sample post, it's gonna be the name of your URL /sample-post. Versus some of these other options which add in dates or just have, you know, weird strings that relate to the database structure of your website, things like that we don't want. So we want to make sure we click on post name and then click on save changes. Everything you do in WordPress, you always want to make sure you click on save changes after you've changed the setting. Then we'll just go to general. We'll just make sure that it added in our site title that we wanted and tagline. Did that, no problem, that's good. Now the next thing here, not that important, but it's good to have like your time zone set up. So if you scroll up to the top here, it's going to have it by region and city. So I'm currently in the United States, and right now I'm working from the East Coast, so I'm going to set the time zone for New York. Then select the date format that you like to use and the time format that you like to use and which day your week starts on. And then click Save Changes. There we go. So the next thing is just go under Posts. We just want to remove any posts that we didn't add to our website ourselves. So we can just click on trash here, and that's gonna put the post in the trash, and then we can delete it if we want to. I'm just gonna leave it there in the trash, that's fine. It's not posted to our website. Let's go over to pages, just do the same thing. Make sure there's no extra pages on here. So that's good. Comments, get rid of comment, any extra comments, and then let's just check in what plugins they've already installed for us. So we've got this Hello Dolly plugin. I'm not too sure what it does. I always just delete it. Something that comes from WordPress. It's pretty much unnecessary. Akismet anti-spam, really important plugin. It's gonna keep your website from getting a bunch of spam comments. It helps filter that out. It is something that you have to get an API key and pay for. It's definitely worthwhile. I do believe that that comes with the sort of next level of Jetpack. And Jetpack is a bundle of a bunch of different utilities for your website. Makes a lot of things easier. Definitely something I recommend having. I actually have the sort of next level up, the pro version of it, which also includes backups. So it has off-site backups, so it's removed from my hosting account. And then it also has a check to make sure that your website hasn't been hacked. And some levels of the Jetpack also include a content delivery network for your images. So it's gonna help your images to load faster. And Jetpack, even the base version here, which is already pre-installed, has got some great, easy to read statistics for your website, so you can see how well your website's performing. So you do need to sign up for Jetpack and just sort of connect it to a WordPress.com account. It's free to do. I definitely recommend doing it. Just take the time and set it up. You can do that by just clicking on the Jetpack button and then click to connect to Jetpack, or to create a free account here. Definitely recommend doing that. Really easy to do. I'm not gonna walk you through how to do it. It's fairly self-explanatory, but there's Jetpack. So the loginizer is what I asked it to add. So the default settings for the loginizer are pretty good, so I just leave that alone. If you do wanna look at the settings, you can click on settings here, and then brute force, and then you can adjust any settings you might wanna adjust. Let's go back to plugins. And then the SiteGround Optimizer is a plugin that's gonna help your website load faster. And I think that's sort of the secret to why I found that SiteGround has gotten such a good performance on the PageSpeed Insight score is this plugin right here. So good thing to have, leave it on there. Okay, so that's got the basics of getting our website all set up and configured. And in the next video, I'm gonna give you some quick tips on some website design. And I wanna give you the website design tips just before we install a theme, because I think that you can apply some of those website design tips into the theme as we install it, and then we can use it to configure our theme so we can start building our pages faster. Now, the theme that I recommend using is the Divi theme, and I have a review of the Divi theme, so I'll link to that right up here. And if you want to check that out for yourself, it's a really great theme. I've been really impressed with the developers and how much they've been improving the theme over the years. And we've got a huge library, as I said before, of free page templates. And then I've got tutorials that'll show you how to build pages with the Divi theme. So if you're ready to continue, go ahead and either click on the web design tutorial that I have next, or if you just want to just jump in and start building your site, click on the intro to the Divi theme, where I'll show you how to install a premium WordPress theme and then how to configure it.